you pleased with the effort tonight, Victor?
Sorry?
Were you pleased with the overall effort tonight, how you guys, you know, rallied, tried to come back?
Yeah. That was a more solid game from us. We're definitely on the right path, you know, and we can see a lot of potential watching those games, I think. So it's what we take from the game, besides the frustration of losing, it's all positive, you know. It's a contender to the title, and, you know, we did almost a good job, you know.
Looked like you were more assertive getting in the lane as well. Was that the case tonight?
I don't know. You tell me. But I'm definitely going to watch film, and we're going to watch what worked and what didn't work and keep doing what's working.
Yeah, a pair of games against four potential Hall of Fame players. What did you learn? What did you pick up from them and how they approached the game?
What do you say, pair of games?
Yeah, numbers, back to back.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Very, obviously, very experienced team. Yeah, it's people that are almost impossible to trick. You know, they don't make a lot of mistakes. They don't fall for fakes, for basic tactics. You know, so it's a good challenge. But we responded the right way in most moments tonight, and soon it's gonna be even better.
Victor, what was your reaction to Pop's taking the mic and asking the fans to stop booing for him?
I mean, my reaction was just, I didn't have the reaction. I was during the game, you know, but it's, I mean, to me, it's, of course, looking back, it's an interesting moment, but it's nothing to make noise about. I think it's definitely not a big deal to me.
When we talked to Devin this morning, he mentioned you guys had a players meeting. Zach kind of talking just about getting things right. Well, do you think that has helped you guys in the last two games kind of take steps where you want to go?
Yeah, definitely. You know, any communication is good inside the team, and we're lucky to have a very, you know, good connection with each other. You know, we hold each other accountable, but there's never like bad intentions, and it's the right it's the right mindset, you know, we have right now.
You did not take a field goal in the first quarter. I think you did one, but you got fouled on it. Was that a conscious decision to kind of ease into the game, or just something that happened?
I mean, it just happened, you know. It's I didn't take a field goal, but I don't think I refused an open field goal either. So it means that I think I made the right choices, you know. We had a good first quarter, so it's there must be things to correct, but we're mostly good.
What did you see from Jeremy in terms of pressuring the rim and finding guys, and then also, you know, just sort of getting guys together, little leadership things?
Yeah, you know, it's Pop told us about our, you know, our competitiveness coming back to the locker room, and we have leaders in the team. Jeremy's part of them, and it's good, you know. He's learning a new role, but at the same time, we're here to help him, and he's also here reassuring us. And you know, he's proving every day, and it's I'm glad we have such a solid, you know, mental basis in our team.
Victor, I'm from Athens, Greece. We have Mattia Lezor and Mustafa Fall in our league. Do you want to send them a message?
I mean, I think they're doing pretty good, so I'm glad. And, you know, it's good to see such dominant players in to be French.
A little off topic, so I apologize, but Nico Batum, you know, many people consider Tony Parker the Jordan of French basketball. What does that make Nico Batum?
I never heard anyone say, I mean, say he was the Jordan of French basketball, but the greatest of French basketball, yes, but the Jordan.
No, Tony's the Jordan.
Oh, okay. I mean, Well, doesn't, I mean, obviously, you know, Nico and Tony are both part of a great generation of French basketball, and I don't know, I don't know if it's possible to make any comparisons, but he's definitely a very, you know.
What has he meant to you throughout your very early career?
He's been, you know, he's given me a few advice, but always very smart and very, you know, he's a, outside of basketball, of the court, he's a very, you know, tranquil, like a good person, and he's, yeah, he's smart also, and he knows his basketball culture is just all the way up there, so it's somebody that it's always good to hear from.
Vic, you mentioned Jeremy earlier as being one of the leaders on the team. What is y'all's relationship like off the court?
Good, you know, healthy. You know, we, as I mentioned before, we don't have any trouble holding each other accountable and talking to each other, being honest. And, you know, it's most of us in the team, almost all of us are young guys learning a new role and a new life, you know, a new job. So we have similarities and we can, you know, we can talk and help each other in many ways.
Thanks, we got one in French.
Victor, deux questions en une. La première sur Moussa Diabaté, est-ce que tu n'as pas joué ensemble avec, mais qu'est-ce que tu penses un petit peu de lui? Est-ce que tu dirais que cette série de 10 défaites de suite en NBA, c'est le moment le plus difficile, mais le plus formateur un petit peu de ta jolie carrière?
Moussa Diabaté, oui, c'est... c'est... À tous les niveaux dans lesquels il a joué, de ce que j'ai vu, il a toujours été solide et très bon défenseur et excellent rebondeur. Et pour les 10 défaites d'affilée, c'est disons que j'ai pas encore le recul pour ça, pour tirer des conclusions, parce que c'est tout ce que je connais pour l'instant de la NBA, mais pour l'instant ça va, on garde la tête fraîche.
Qu'est-ce que tu as appris de ces...